It's an absolute delight to host you this evening for our first Australia Day reception for some time. And of course, the first Australia Day since the election of the government of Prime Minister Rabuka. I wanted to begin, if I could, by acknowledging some special guests who are loitering at the back there. General Angus Campbell, the Chief of the Australian Defence Force, and his spouse, Stephanie Copus Campbell. And Air Marshal Kevin Short, Chief of the New Zealand Defence Force, and Cheryl Short. They are travelling together this week to Fiji, New Caledonia, Vanuatu, Solomon Islands and Tonga to build on the already strong security cooperation across our Pacific family. Thank you so much to Minister Tiko Duadua and General Kalunawai for hosting such excellent discussions today. A special mention too, if I can, for Stephanie Copus Campbell and congratulations to her on her recent appointment as Australia's new Ambassador for Gender Equality. We're very much look forward to working with you, Ambassador, in the years ahead to support Fijian women and girls. There's much our two countries can do together and genuinely learn from each other. And no more important way of unlocking the full potential of our families, our communities and our economies than supporting gender equality and women's economic empowerment. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to host tonight so many members of the new Fijian government of Prime Minister Rabuka. We look forward to working with you very closely in the years ahead to support your priorities, building on Australia's work over many years as a partner for Fiji in education, in health, in media, in business and economic reform and governance, in climate resilience, in security, humanitarian and disaster response, and regional and global affairs. Australia's partnership with Fiji has never been stronger. We see our Vuvale partnership, signed back in September 2019, as more than just a framework for the extensive range of cooperation between Australia and Fiji. For Australia, Vuvale is much more. It's a cultural shift, recognising not just the importance of Fiji for our national interests, but also the need to engage each other in the spirit of genuine two-way partnership, as equals, as family, listening and engaging. And as a bipartisan partnership, enduring beyond changes of government in Australia and Fiji. I wanted to acknowledge, though, tonight the presence of former Prime Minister Bainimarama and a number of members of the former government, and also thank them sincerely for their excellent contribution to bilateral relations over many years. Ladies and gentlemen, Australia Day is an important theme of reflection for our time of reflection for our people. We have much to celebrate as a diverse, vibrant, contemporary society actively engaged in world affairs. People from almost every country on earth have chosen to make Australia their home, and we are enriched by this diversity in so many ways. But we also have much history to reflect on. 2023 will be an important year in our national journey of healing with Indigenous Australians, the first peoples of our continent, as we seek to deliver on their calls for a voice to the Australian Federal Parliament, recognised in our Constitution. Internationally, we will continue to build First Nations perspectives into the heart of Australian foreign policy, including here in the Pacific, supported by a new appointment, an Ambassador for First Nations people. We look forward to the incoming Ambassador's work here in the Pacific. I'm delighted today, having just spoken to Secretary General Henry Puna, that Australia's Assistant Minister for Indigenous Affairs, Senator Malandiri McCarthy, was able to zoom into a Pacific Islands Forum Australia Day event today with the Secretary General and his team to share her unique views on Australia Day as a leader among our First Nations people. Ladies and gentlemen, before I finish, there are some people we would like to thank for supporting this event tonight. We're delighted to be partnering Digicel Fiji tonight. It's our first major opportunity to showcase a substantial and strategic Australian investment in the Pacific in the vital sector of telecommunications. Telstra's recent acquisition of Digicel will pave the way for greater connectivity and customer service in Fiji and across the Pacific, building on the existing business and capitalising on Telstra's world-leading expertise and equipment. So our sincere thanks to Digicel CEO Farid Mohammed and his team for coming on board with us this evening. We're excited too to have with us here tonight V5. This phenomenal teenage band were winners of the Australian High Commission's 2022 Domo Vuvale, I hope I got that right, Domo Vuvale original music competition, and but one of example of Fiji's incredible musical talent. They'll be playing a selection of Australian favourites, you've heard some already, along with their Domo Vuvale winning composition, Mango Tree. I'm happy to say V5 are highly versatile and are already fielding a number of requests this evening. I understand someone in the Prime Minister's office has requested Let Love Shine by Amos. Judging by his grin, it might have been the Prime Minister himself. In an act of great courage, a guest from the Fijian Elections Office has requested Glitch by Taylor Swift. We might have that one on repeat for around 4 or 5 hours later this evening. And a Sedelpa party guest, who has asked to remain anonymous, has requested Let's Stick Together by Al Green. Ladies and gentlemen, we are also pleased to present tonight a selection of Australian canapé, featuring local Fijian produce infused with Australian native herbs, fruit and oils. Like Fiji, Australia is blessed with an amazing variety of native plants, and our First Nations people have been utilising these for thousands of years. Tonight's canapés were prepared by a team of cookery staff and former students of the Australia Pacific Training Coalition, the APTC, our long-standing skills training program here in Fiji and across the Pacific. All of them have been now employed by the local tourism industry here in Fiji, and we thank them for volunteering to be part of our celebrations here this evening. And complementing these canapés, I encourage everyone here tonight to take the time to visit over to our left, Carvalicious and the Gingerlay beer tables. These Fijian entrepreneurs are graduates of Australia's Fiji Enterprise Engine, an initiative of our market development facility, in this case delivered through the Fijian Commerce and Employers Federation. We're absolutely thrilled to be supporting new and exciting Fijian SMEs, such an important driver for growth everywhere. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you again for joining us this evening to help us celebrate Australia's National Day. I'd very much welcome if you could join me in a toast. A toast, ladies and gentlemen, to the President, the government and the people of the Republic of Fiji.